So, dear friends, we had been classifying the tracheal system in insects. And due to some technical glitch, it went off. We are just having a revision of this. So, the classification of tracheal system in insects. I'm Professor S. Andarandale from College of Agriculture, Sonai. You have seen this cockroach respiratory system. The scheme of classification of tracheal system elaborated by Kellin and Hinton based on number and location of the functional spiracles. This classification done as polyneuistic, oligoneuistic, anoistic, hyponeuistic and hyperneuistic. In polyneuistic, holoneuistic, minimum 8 pairs are functional, means all 10 are functional here, 2 plus 8, 1 from meso and 1 from metathoracic segments, 8 pairs in abdomen. Polyneuistic, minimum 8 pairs. Perineuistic, 9 are functional. 1 plus 8 means 1 from mesothorax and 8 pairs in abdomen. Then hemineuistic, 8 pairs functional, 1 from mesothorax and 7 from the anterior abdominal segments. Oligoneuistic again, you can see that they are having 1 to 2 pairs of spiracles functional. Amphineuistic, first example is there. It is having working or functional pairs, that is first pair of thorax, that is mesothorax, and one pair in abdomen. Then metanoistic, one pair is functional of abdominal last segment. Then pronoistic, mesothoracic, one segment or one pair is functional. It is only mesothoracic segmental pleural spiracle. Then anoistic, these are not having functional spiracles. The respiratory system is completely blocked, or you may say it is completely closed. The oxygen is absorbed by the skins or gills through diffusion. The aquatic and endoparasitic larvae, aquatic larvae present in water, they will have this respiration. Maybe they may have some gills, or they may utilize this diffusion for getting the oxygen. And also the endoparasitic larvae, which are inside the body of the host, means in biological control agents, this type of system you may see. And these endoparasitic larvae, they sustain or live inside their host body by respiring in such a manner of diffusion. Anoistic. Now from here our video continues. The fourth one is hyponeuistic. One or more pairs of spiracles are degenerated or they disappear completely. So as all of us know that there are 10 pairs of spiracles, but what happens here, even if there are 10, the number gets reduced in latter part of their life cycle. So the total number of spiracular pairs is less than 10. The examples are Malophaga, Siphonculata, Thysanoptera, etc. Hypo means less than 10, less hypo. Then hypernoistic. Now what is this hyper? Hyper is more in number. So we know that there are 10 spiracular pairs to be normal. And the hypernoistic, hyper means on the higher side, more than 10, they may contain 11 or maybe beyond that, what the research may say. And two pairs in mesothorax, this is just an example I'm quoting. Two pairs in mesothorax, one pair in metathorax, this may be altered, it may be two pairs in meso, two pairs in metathorax, and eight pairs in abdomen, means the number should go beyond 10 pairs. So hypernoistic will contain more than 10 pairs of spiracles. The examples diplurans, the japix, 4 plus 7. Now here you may say in the earlier example it is shown 2 and 1 and 8. Now here this example, it may vary. Japix is having 4 spiracular pairs in its thoracic segments, and in the abdominal segment it is having 7. So this is all about your classification of tracheal system in insects. So both the parts you have to see, and when you watch both the parts you will get the whole idea. Thank you.